coming to Vanand Hall. Hope all are doing good at your homes in these pandemic situations. First of all, I would like to thank our society for giving this wonderful opportunity to reach my lovely students. Coming to here, I am K. Krishna Lakshmi, Faculty of English, TTWRDC, Devil Korea. So, coming to our today's session, I would like to discuss one of the very important topic in English language, that is pronunciation. So, pronunciation is very important topic and it plays a vital role in everyone's conversation. Being a non-native people, we do so many mispronunciations in our daily conversation. So, here I am going to give some techniques to overcome that mispronunciation and try to be a native speakers. So, further, today I would like to discuss one of the important topic in pronunciation, that is phonetics. So, here phonetics. Phonetics, I am going to give the definition of phonetics. What is phonetic? Phonetic is a scientific study of speech sounds. So, here we are studying about the speech sounds in a scientific way. So, how to pronounce the sounds in a scientific way? We are going to study the sounds. So, phonetics are a scientific study of speech sounds in English language. So, here who are making or who are giving the list of phonetics? So, here IPA. So, IPA is a International Phonetic Alphabet. International Phonetic Alphabet. So, here IPA is made the list of phonetics. Here in English language, we have 26 alphabets, right? Am I right, students? We have 26 alphabets. In the 26 alphabets, again we have divided 21 or, yes, exactly, consonants. And remain 5 are absolutely vowels. 21 are consonants and remain 5 are vowels. What are the vowels? A, E, I, O, U. These are the vowels. So, totally we have 26 alphabets in English language. So, from the 26 alphabets, 44 sounds. We are, IPA created 44 phonetic sounds. 44 phonetic sounds. So, here phonetics are 44. How many? 44. So, here the IPA is representing the symbols of phonemes and representing the correct pronunciation. By using IPA, we can pronounce properly and correctly in the various languages. See, so here phonetics are 44 according to phonetics, IPA. So, again these phonetics are divided into consonant sounds. Consonant sounds and vowel sounds. So, consonant sounds are 24. Consonant sounds are 24 and vowel sounds are 20. Consonant sounds are 24 and vowel sounds are 20. So, coming to vowel sounds. See, here, coming to vowel sounds, we have 5 vowel alphabets in English language that are A, E, I, O, U. From that, A, E, I, O, U, again, IPA derived 20 vowel sounds. From 5 alphabets, IPA derived 20 alphabets in English language. So, coming to here. Again, these vowel sounds are divided into two types. sound. Monophthong is a vowel sound which includes a single sound within a single syllable. Which includes a single sound, okay, within a single syllable. So again, I am repeating the definition of monophthong or pure vowels. So monophthong is a vowel which contains single vowel sounds within a single syllable. So again, here monophthongs are pure vowels are 12. How many monophthongs are pure vowels are, my dear students? Yes, absolutely. There are 12 monophthongs are pure vowels in the English language according to IPA. So here we can see. So E, E, U, U, A, A, I, E, A, 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 A. So this we have to practice. We can't learn in a single day or in a overnight. So we have to practice, keep on practice, then only we will get some hand in that. So here I am pronunciating the sounds. Please follow me. So here E, E, O, U, A, A, E, A, E, A, O, O. So this is the way of pronunciation of monophthongs. Let us see the example. See, according to the definition, monophthong is a vowel sound which contains a single sound within a syllable. So here, for your understanding, who came from Telugu medium, even they can understand easily. For their convenience, I here wrote Telugu alphabets also, Telugu Varnamala also I wrote. So here this E represents in Telugu Varnamala E sound. See here H. So here the sound is E, and here sit. It's a industry. So here E. This is, remember my dear students, E. This sound is E. And coming to next one, E. E. So here feel, each, even, these. Okay, so here this sound is E, each, even, these. So here we are enlarging our lips, enlarging our mouth when we are uttering, articulating this sound, we are enlarging our mouth. But here we are not. As usually we are saying E. But here E. So here feel, each, even, these. Okay? So this is the difference between E and E. Come to the another one. U. Here we say book, look, full. See, you can observe the mouth comes forward. See, here we are enlarging, but here we are forwarding. We are bringing into front side. So book, look, full. See, you have to observe the speech organs. You have to observe the speech organs, the lips and the teeth, the tongue, the position of tongue, the position of mouth, and the teeth. Here, book, look, full. See, it resembles in Telugu U, U sound. Come to here, U. Here, U, U. So, amuse. See, we are here, we are using use, amuse, food. Yes, most of the people, they used to say food, but it is not food, it's a food. So, here, food. here we can use a sound. Catch, honest, office. Okay? Please remember this. A sound. This is a sound. Telugu Varnamala. In Telugu Varnamala, a. Catch, honest, office. So this resembles Telugu a. And coming to here, a.
Ea, ea, ua,
So for this big town, we can see the examples ear, hear, cheer, and dear. Okay. So coming to next one, ar, ar. The vowel sounds two are combining and giving one single sound. So air, chair. Air, chair, parent, bear, bear. Okay? Air, chair, parent, parent, and bear, and dear. So these are two diphthongs. And coming to another diphthong. Ua, ua. So, tua, poor, poor, and sensual. Your jury, jury. Okay, your core sensual your jury. So these are the examples. And coming to next one here. A, is, pray, obey, way, and break. A sound, A E. These two single sounds are combining and giving a single sound. So here, A's, pray, obey, way, and break. Okay, break. So again, coming to here, I, A, E, A, E. These sounds are combining and giving a single syllable. They are entering into, they are combining into a single syllable. So I, pie, sight, shine. So here I, again here you can see I, shine. I, pie, shine, sign, shine. So coming to next one, I. This is I. Here it is I. It is a I. Oi, oyster, coin, wise, eyes, boy, oi. See, a plus e, a plus e, giving I sound, I sound. Oil, oyster, coin, wise, boy. So coming to next one, ow, ow. So go, bowl, show, now, cold. See, come again. Go, bowl, show, now, and cold. So we have to use, no, don't say go, 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 bowl. Okay? So like this, show. Okay? So oh, 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 no, ow. So coming to ow, ow. So owl, owl. Count, aunt. We are not saying aunt. We are saying aunt, aunt, aunt. Sound, now, and loud. So here, owl, count, sound, now, and loud. And these are the 8 diphthongs in phonetics, which are made by IPA, International Phonetic Alphabet. So I hope you understand well the vowel sounds. So I'm going to discuss about the consonant sounds. Yes, shall we go into consonant sounds? Yes, we shall. So again here, according to IPA, from 21 alphabets, from 21 consonant alphabets, okay, we have IPA derived 24 consonant sounds. How many? 24 consonant sounds. Okay, from that 24 sounds, again we have divided the consonant sounds into 5 types. How many types? 5 types. Let me tell that. Okay. First one is plosives. Plosives. Okay. Next one. Prosims and fricatives. And the third one is affricatives, affricates. And the fourth one is nasals. Okay? And the fifth one is approximants. Plosives, fricatives, affricates, nasals and approximants. Okay, we will discuss later about that. First, let us come to the point. I have told that there are 24 consonant sounds. Let us see what are the 24 consonant sounds. So here, P, B, T, D, K, G, F, F, V, T. Okay? D, S, Sh, J, Z, H, H, M, N, N. And here, ra, ya, la, va. Ra, ya, la, va. Don't get confused here. This is not J, this is ya. The sound is ya. So here, see. First, let us see. Ha. In Telugu, it resembles pa sound. Okay? Being a native speakers, we are from Telugu. Okay? Our mother tongue is Telugu. So most of our mother tongue is Telugu. So I resemble it here. Ko English phonetic ko resembles Telugu varnamala ha. So pin, spin, ship. Here the initial position you take in any position in the verb. It may be initial, it may be middle, it may be the last, final position. Okay? So it becomes at any position. So it is an initial position, it is a middle position, and it's a final position. So here we can take the verb pin, spin, ship. In this word, the first sound came in the first position, initial position, and in this word, the first sound came in the middle position. And in this word, the first sound came in the final position. And coming to here, B. Next word, B. B sound. B, beach, club, or hub. So, like in our Telugu, B sound. Like beach, club, hub. And coming to here, T sound. T sound. Retreat. T sound. Retreat, store, T sound, and leech, T sound. And here, D sound. The sound is here, D. D sound, D, D. In first position, initial position, D. In that word, D. And in goal, the position came, the sound came in final position. Here also you can see in the final position in that word. And K, K sound. K sound here. Key, sky, top. And here, like C also pronunciating K sound. C also, see? We read like this alphabet like C. But here we are pronunciating the sound K. K. So, K, 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 and K. So, see, for example, I will tell one example here, my ears. Access, access. See, here one C is pronunciating K sound and another C is pronunciating S sound. So, that's why to overcome that mispronunciation, okay, do not get confused, we have to learn phonetics. So here you can see the best example, access. So in this, these are the same alphabets, but one alphabet is pronunciating the K sound, the another alphabet is pronunciating as S sound. So if we know very well ga. In first position, middle position, and final position. The sound may come at any position in the verb. Okay, next one, f sound. So, f, fan, spear, spear, half, half, f sound. And coming to v sound, we have to pronounce v. There is a confusion, my dears. V between V and W. There is a confusion between V and W. How we have to pronounce it? See, when we have to pronounce it, V. Say V. 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 Vanish. Vase. Okay? But here, woman. Woman. Walk. Work. See? You can observe easily in my movement of my speech areas. When I am pronunciating the wash, vanish, vanish. But here, woman, woman. Okay? So, I want to tell one joke or whatever here. One person went to a restaurant. There, he asked the server boy. So, I want to vomit. He said, I want to vomit. So, this sentence conveyed to the server, he thought that, okay, I'll take and I will vomit. Vomit. See, he thought that he wanted to take that bowl and he want to warm, heat that. But actually the customer's thought is, the customer's intention is, you want to vomit, vomit, vomit. But he said vomit. No, it's not vomit, it's a vomit. So, we have to be very careful in verb and verb. Verb and verb. Okay? And here, view, peace, land. Okay? And here, this is th sound. This is th. Th. Th sound. So, breath, think, bath. Breath, think, and bath. And this is the sound. This is the sound. Then, clothes. Clothes. It's not clothes, it's a clothes. Okay? I'm going to hear some sound. Some. Sit. Taste. Loss. Some. Some. But here it is, we can see there is a lot of confusion. It's a sa sound and it's a sha sound. It's a sha. Large S sound. Large S. Sha. Ship. Wish. Fresh. Sh. Sh. Sound. This is a s sound and this is a sh sound. So, ship, wish, and fresh. Come to here. Je, ja, ja. Okay? Zoo, zoo, buzz, laws. Zoo, buzz, laws. Okay? So, that is. And here it is a ja sound. Ja, ja. Pressure. Pleasure, division, division, okay, and rouse, z sound, za, sound, ja, okay, coming to here, ha, sound, ha, ha, hatch, behave, hat, okay, hat, behave, hat, and here, ma, main, small, sum, ma, sound. And here, na sound. Na. 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 Snake. Shine. Name. Snake. Shine. Na sound. And ing. Ng. Ng sound. Ng song. Sing. And ping. Okay. And coming to here, cha and cha. Cha and cha. Cha. Fetch, chi, and teach. Ch, ch, and ch. And here, b, jam, jam, jam. Judge, judge, jai, lodge. Okay, so this is a j sound. And coming to here, r, r sound. Arrange, shrew, and round. Okay, this is r sound. And this is y, y. It is not j. See, y. Okay, here, s, l, o, q, u. Okay, y sound. And coming to here, l, light, late, slate. Okay, this is the l sound. And coming to here, v, v. Okay, win, van, woman. Win, van, woman. Okay, so this is a v sound. So in consonant sounds, okay, in phonetics we have 24 consonant sounds. Okay, so I hope you will understand. Okay, and see once again I'm pronunciating. P, b, t, d, f, g, f, v, th, d, s, sh, j, z, h, n, 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 ch, j, r, y, l, v. Okay, these are the 24 consonant sounds. So just now I told that, okay, we have 5 types of semantics. Okay, so these plosives are 6. How many plosives? 6. And how many fricatives? 9 fricatives. And how many affricatives? Affricatives are here 2. And nasals are 3. And approximants are again here 4. Again here 4. So plosives 6. Fricatives 9 and affricatives 2, nasals 3, approximants 4. Okay ma'am, you are saying all plosives, fricatives. How did you divide it? How do you divide it? Okay, how do you divide all these 5 types of consonant sounds? Okay, depending on the manner of articulation. Okay, how you pronounce the manner of articulation, okay, and the only we have divided the manner of articulation, we have divided again the consonant sounds into 5 types. So first, plosives. What is plosives? Plosives are the sounds produced when the air, okay, when the air briefly stopped, okay, briefly stops and then suddenly released. Okay, it stops some time. Okay, and suddenly it releases the sound. Once again, what is plosive? Plosive is a consonant sound produced when the air briefly stops and then alphabet and this is a phonetic. Okay, how do we remember this? A phonetic should be always in between the two slashes. It takes position in between the two slashes. So here, b, ch, d, kh, and g. These are the glossies. See, when I am trying to pronounce it, h. So here, the a is briefly stop and then release it suddenly. So h, b, ch, d, kh, g. So after completion of class, okay, please stand in front of mirror and try to pronunciate the sounds and observe, okay, your speech outcomes. Okay, here we can see the example clauses again. So h, b, ch, d, kh, g. These six are glossies. These six are glossies here. p, b, ch, d, kh, g. So when we are pronouncing the and the sound is producing, the a is suddenly briefly stopping and then releasing suddenly. Okay. P. See, when you are trying to say pronounce p, so in the standing it is briefly stopping and then releasing suddenly. So p, b, ch, d, kh, and g. These are the glossies. And coming to next, fricatives. So what is fricative? Okay, so fricative is the air escapes. The air escapes from a narrow passage in the mouth and causing the hissing and friction sound. Here we have 9 fricatives. Okay, let me tell you once again the definition. Okay, fricatives are the sounds, consonant sounds produced when the air, passing the air passage into a narrow passage into a mouth and causing the friction and hissing sound. See, let us observe. These are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Up to here. Okay, up to. These are the this pink colored border is fricatives or fricatives. F, b, th, d, s, sh, zh, zh, z. And ha. See, when I am pronouncing these sounds, okay, there is a friction or hissing sound. Which combines a plosive okay? And immediately following a fricative, an immediate following a fricative and articulated, okay, same position, at the same position. See, here, See, okay, L is silent and not pronounced, okay, in this, okay, in chop and walk and should and could. Okay, we can't say chal, we can't pronounce it walk, we can't pronounce it should, and we can't pronounce it could. Okay, remember, in these words, L is silent, okay. So, and R, you take R, okay, in a word. When R follows to consonant sound in a word, when R follows consonant sound in a word, R will be unheard. R will be unheard. Means it will be not here. So like heard. Heard. Okay? And form. Okay? So in this, it is R is following consonant sound. And R is following M sound. So M is consonant and D is consonant. So here R is unheard. R is unheard. Okay, next. When R is following vowel sound, it will be audible clearly. When R is following vowel sound, okay, it will be clearly. Like range. Range. So here R is following vowel sound. Okay? And bridge. Bridge. So here R is following vowel sound. Okay? So these are the some important techniques to remember the, to write the spellings and to pronounce the words. Okay. So I hope this today's class on phonetics. Okay? I hope I reach you. And please only don't listen and don't throw aside, okay, after completion of the class. Please watch the video carefully and practice in front of mirror, okay. You can't learn in one day or in one night. We have to be always keep on practice, then only we will become like native speakers, okay. I hope you people understand. And if you have any doubts, please ask your doubts in the comment section. Okay, thank you and be safe, stay safe, stay safe at your homes.